The most common way to do a breast reduction or a breast lift is something called an inferior pedicle. And what an inferior pedicle does is that we leave the tissue at the bottom, we remove all the breast tissue from the top. And from what I was just talking about, you're removing the breast tissue where it has the most blood supply. And also, that's the part of the breast that we want to leave behind, that's the cleavage. So 90% of breast reductions performed are done by this. Another way is so when people start trying to figure out how to leave more breast tissue superiorly, they've come up with called the superior medial pedicle. So we'll leave the nipple attached to some of the breast tissue up at the top. However, in order to get that nipple to rotate up into position, we have to do a lot of back cuts and a lot of thinning out. And what we always worry about is blood supply and nerve supply. Complications of traditional breast reduction. The most important is the early wound complications and delayed wound healing. We see over 20%, that's about 20% rate. That's pretty common, it's usually at the bottom area. There's other things such as fluid collections and of course nipple areal ischemia, you can actually lose a nipple during this procedure, and fat necrosis. The most important thing that I've found from looking at all this literature is that nipple sensation is not listed in any of our complications. And for someone that takes care of a lot of women, does a lot of breast surgery, nipple sensation is a very important part. Liposuction breast reduction is not entirely new. Most people that have talked about it before have talked about it for people that are younger, have good skin quality, they go into just liposuction, just kind of leave the breast hanging. So they've never really looked at it from a cosmetic standpoint. Lajour back in 1994 mentioned it in one of her papers where she talked about a vertical reduction and doing a little bit of liposuction. Actually, she mentioned it was a great ease of operation, but again, nobody's really talked about this or doing this in the mainstream. We've also found that by performing liposuction will remove fat, but the best part about it, though, is that it leaves behind lymphatics and neurovascular supply. And especially for sick people that have lipedema or lymphedema, we can actually perform liposuction, remove the bad fat in the area, and leave the lymphatics behind, which is the most important part. And what's interesting from the other non-surgical talks we were just talking about, it's all about lymphatics, right? It's all about trying to move the fluid throughout the body and get it there because you don't want it to get in. So this is something where we can actually leave a lot of the lymphatics behind. Peter Rubin's paper talked about abdominoplasty. We've all found that the more lymphatics or the more fascia areas we can leave behind, the better healing we have, the less chance we have of fluid buildup. And this is how people started getting into surgeries where we don't use drains at all. A paper that came out actually this year from France is they started calling it the LipoLift. And these are people that have lost a lot of weight in bariatric surgery. They've lost hundreds, 200, 300 pounds. Typically, you wouldn't think these people need liposuction. But what this group in France has found also is when they perform liposuction, remove the fat, and leave a lot of the lymphatics behind, they actually get better healing rates and better outcomes. And this is a population that typically has a lot of wound healing issues. So what I've started doing is what I'm calling a LipoLift procedure. It is a liposuction breast reduction, and the reason I started doing it, the reason I love it, it's a controllable resection. I can take out the breast tissue from the areas that I or the patient doesn't want, and we can leave it behind where they do want it. I'm able to contour the breast better. I mainly remove it from the lateral side and the inferior portion of the part you don't want. We really leave it superiorly. However, it can be done throughout the entire breast, and I'll show you some examples of that. I have a Vectra machine, I have no disclosures. Vectra is a 3D imaging machine, so I can actually measure the breast, and I'll show you that as well, too. It's then a skin-only resection, so we're really minimizing how much surgery we're doing for it. And I don't use drains for this procedure. The other thing I found also is great for secondary reduction. My markings are simple. I mean, I've had to sort of teach this to myself, but what I do in that bottom right photo is I will actually just put the breast up on the chest wall where I want it to sit, and we look at the extra breast tissue. If you look at the lateral mark, that's just all the breast hanging off the side. If you look at the inferior mark, that's just all the breast at the bottom that, again, we don't really want because we want to keep the breast up. Again, this is the Vectra imaging. That's that same patient we saw in the preoperative markings. This is her Vectra image. It shows that there's like 81 cc's more on that side. And what you'll see is during my procedure, then I will just take out exactly that. Whereas for those who've done traditional breast reductions, where you normally open up the whole breast, we're cutting away breast tissue, putting it to the side, weighing in, and going back and forth. And so this is a lot more controllable for me. This is that same exact patient that you just saw. And what you'll see is I finished the liposuction portion. If you look at her breast now, I'm sorry, the angle is not dead on. But if you look at her breast now, I've removed more from the left side, and they're a lot more symmetrical. Once we make them symmetrical, I will then do something called tailor tacking, which means I'll take the breast and we will, this might be graphic, but we staple it to sort of to put everything in place and make sure that we're symmetrical and find out where we want to place the nipple areola complex. And you'll see that's a great breast shape for her. The next phase, I will actually draw on where I want the nipple areola complex. We'll measure everything out, and then I draw little hash marks to see where everything's going to line up after, because now we have to take the skin off of the breast. The next phase is what's called deepavitalization. I do this with a 10-blade knife. It's actually really fast with it, and find the best way to do it, because I can leave a lot of the dermis behind, especially where the lymphatics are, and really just remove the superior skin. Really fast, but I didn't know how much time I had to talk, so watching surgery, not normally that fast, but yeah, that's what it looks like. If you sort of take it off the skin from the area, it's called a WISE pattern, which is the most standard way to sort of lift the breast. The next phase, I do have to make small incisions, and what I do with older breast reduction is you will undermine all the way to bring the skin together. With this, I undermine just enough to get the skin closed, so it's very little tension, very little. Every time the more you undermine, the more blood supply you cut from the skin. One of the most important things that I actually had to sort of teach myself is at the top portion above the nipple, it's called your superior pedicle, even though the whole thing is really attached because it's liposuction. But I don't want to cut that area. I really want to leave that behind as much as possible. So what I've started doing is I'll take two double-pronged skin hooks. And I'll actually do this more bluntly so that I'm actually, again, not disturbing any of the blood supply. I give myself a little tiny window, and then with my finger, I will just move everything around so I can get the nipple to move up. Again, when you do that, you leave all the nerve and all the blood supply behind. And you'll see I do this on both sides, and then I'm able to actually really just move the nipple and put it into position. And then the next part is, you can see it closes really easily. The next part is just the closure. That is the same patient you just saw. That was her pre-op. You saw her Vectra, you saw her surgery, and this is her before and afters now. You'll see that her left breast was lower, she's a lot more symmetrical now, and a lot happier with her size. Another patient, a lot larger, again, you took the tissue mainly from the lateral side. And one thing you see, if you look, seeing people that have breast reduction, a lot of times the breast is either flat and wide, or they have a lot on the side. These people, we can really contour them. Another patient, very similar, pretty large, we're able to reduce a lot of her breast from the size from the bottom and really give her, and if you look at where her nipples are from her belly button, you can see how much we've actually lifted her. Another patient, this is actually more of the typical patients that I see when I started doing this procedure. A lot of women after breastfeeding will really get severe asymmetry. I mean, we do things like keratosis, and the right breast is called keratoretosis, which is the worst. The left breast is keratosis, which is still pretty bad. But with this, with the asymmetries and even with the nipple position, we can still take away from the breast where we want to, leave what we want to behind, and get her more symmetric. Here's another similar patient, left side is larger and lower. We're able to kind of get her to get everything a lot more symmetric for her and get the breast a lot more proportionate for her. This patient actually, this photo was actually from about a week or so ago. We did that before and after at the bottom to kind of show how the lift was. If you look at her preoperative photo in the upper left, you'll actually see sort of indentations at the top of her breast. She's actually young. She's about 24, 25. She's been so large for so long. I felt like her breasts were actually dislocated from her chest. And we talked about blood supply and healing and stuff like that. We did our LipoLift procedure, and we were actually able to get her breasts up there and had no healing issues. This is actually, this from actually this past week. This is a very large breast. I took about a liter per breast, a little more on one of the sides that was bigger. The interesting thing was I had to lipo the entire breast. I want to show that you can do this. You don't have to leave any areas behind. If you really have to just really decrease things and make things smaller, it's great. Again, look at where her nipples are compared to her belly button, and then the same thing. So far, what we've seen with our patient population, we've not had any complication, any major complications, no matter if you go back to the operating room or anything like that. Minor complications, about 6% with my healing. That's comparable to literature, just our overall literature is over 20% of healing issues. I've had one patient that had the weirdest thing that I've seen. She actually had a hyperemia. Her breast, which is bilateral symmetrical redness, was not infection. And I happen to think it's because we leave so much blood supply behind. That was sort of my theory after. She had to say it just resolved on its own. Subjectively, I've had no loss of nipple sensation. In fact, a few of those patients that I just showed you actually had zero nipple sensation prior to this procedure because their breasts were so large that they've been stretching out the nerves for so long. After my procedure, they've all been hypersensitive. My patients take Tylenol after surgery. I've not had any narcotics, which is amazing for me. I really don't like narcotic medications at all. And the other thing I like about this subjectively is, you saw, I can better correct for asymmetries that women do have. The difference in the exam that I do. So when people would come in and I would just talk about breast reduction, you have the standard thing, which you say, well, we're gonna take out a whole bunch and close it. Now I really have to feel. Liposuction will not remove breast tissue. So I really do a full breast exam to see how much breast tissue there is versus how much subcutaneous tissue there is, and make sure that that's the amount we want to remove. I will have a discussion with them and say, if I can't get things small enough, I may have to open it over to a traditional breast reduction. I've not had to do that yet, but it is a discussion I have with them preoperatively. For the future, I mean, I really want to start this as a kind of research, and I'm really looking at, following our outcomes. So what I'm going to start looking at is taking my preoperative mammograms, which all of my patients, especially over 40, get, and start correlating them with their clinical about a year later with their mammograms to see just sort of how they